The human asked, "Why do I feel that it's not Ramadan and it's not Eid? The feeling and the atmosphere that I had when I was young was missing." When people ask me to give a reason about their feeling, it's difficult for me to answer that question because I'm not them. I can't tell you the reason for your feeling because it's your feeling. But what I can tell you is a possible reason for why you are feeling that feeling. A possible reason why you might feel that it's not Ramadan or you might feel that it's not Eid is because you hold on to the idea of how Eid is and how Ramadan is based upon your childhood. So you hold on to those memories and you hope that those memories will repeat themselves over and over and over again. Putting the situation in that perspective, you can see why that particular belief might be a bit flawed because nothing stays the same. Things change because people change and cultures change, especially in this day and age where change is happening so fast. But there are things that should not change. These things are universals. They transcend time and place. No matter when or where, these things are always important, always relevant, and should always be adhered to. And these things are what make up our principles. Principles should not change, but the way in which we apply those principles can change. Let's take Eid as a case study. What is the principle behind Eid? Eid, in principle, is about celebration. It's about joyous occasion. It's about being happy. But how do we apply those principles? It depends. It varies according to time and place. The way we celebrate Eid 20 years ago is so different than the way we celebrate Eid today. Ask your parents, they will know. One of the things that we don't like to hear coming from our elders is the phrase, "When I was your age," because we know what comes after that phrase is most probably going to be a negative comment about our generation. But whether you like it or not, whether you realize it or not, you too might be using the same phrase when you get older. You might be using that phrase now. You might be telling your little brothers or your little cousins right now, "When I was your age, this is not how I celebrate Eid." I think it's one of those things that becomes so common that we don't even realize it. I mean, our father's generation will comment about our generation. Our generation will comment about the next generation, and so on and so forth. But we have to make peace with the fact that things change. The way we celebrate Eid changes. It is changing and it will continue to change as time goes by. That's how life is. Things change. But that doesn't have to be a bad thing. The good thing that we can get from this realization is that we should cherish the moments while they still last. Because pretty soon, they will all be gone. And the things that remain from them are sweet memories. And yes, we can remind ourselves about all those sweet memories that we had before. But we should not live in them. Things change, for better or for worse. Not all changes are good, obviously. We should always filter these changes according to our principles. If those changes are in line with our principles, then we should welcome them, even though we don't prefer them. As for Eid, as long as it remains a celebration where people gather together to solidify bonds of kinship and friendship, where people enjoy themselves in a halal and good way, where people increase in gratitude, where the old love the young and the young respect the old, and where the theme of the day is love and compassion, then we don't really have a reason to complain. But we have every reason to be happy. Eid is a time of celebration, of appreciation, of gratitude, so there's a lot of